Welcome to my channel Lenovate. In this video, we will going to discuss about the glycemic index and glycemic load. Also, we will going to discuss the ranges of the normal glycemic index and the foods that contain the high or low glycemic index. At the end of video, we will also going to comparison between the glycemic index and the glycemic load. By these handwritten notes, I hope you will be explained well. So, starting from the definition of glycemic index. So the glycemic index is a relative ranking of a dietary carbohydrate depending upon how quickly the carbohydrate raises your blood glucose level. You can say the glycemic index is a rank that is given to each food or carbohydrate that how quickly it will going to increase your blood glucose level. The carbohydrate that increase your blood glucose level, suddenly they are considered as a high glycemic index foods. While the carbohydrates that does not increase your glucose level suddenly, or they cause normal or slow increase in your blood glucose, they are considered as a low glycemic index food. Like the fibers, the dietary fibers, they are considered as a low glycemic index food. While the chocolates, the candies, the cakes we eat, they are all considered as a high glycemic index food because they are causing the sudden rise in our blood glucose level. So this is about the glycemic index definition. Now coming to the glycemic index range and the foods that contain high or low glycemic index. The low glycemic index, the value of normal glycemic index is about 56 to 69. That is a normal glycemic index present in carbohydrate, and we should eat that food frequently with the normal glycemic index. But the glycemic index less than 55 is considered to be as low. And the foods that contain the low glycemic index include the apples and the wheat. And they are good food to eat more because they have low glycemic index and they will not going to increase your blood glucose level. They will not going to shoot your blood glucose. So they are good food to eat. Then we have the median glycemic index food. The 56 to 69 range is medium glycemic index. And the food contained these are sucrose and the brown rice and the bread. The high glycemic index food that contain the glycemic index greater than 70. They are cakes, chocolates, dairy products, juices and white rice. So we should eat with these food with caution, or we should avoid the food that contain the high glycemic index. Because the high glycemic index also related with certain of the health risk factors, include the diabetic type 2. The diabetes that may cause because of the increase in the amount of fluctuation of blood glucose and increased release of insulin that may lead to the diabetes type 2, or it may cause any other chronic conditions in our body. So we should avoid the high glycemic index food. Now coming to the formula that is used to find the glycemic index food in the laboratory. In the laboratory, we use a graph that is plotted against a reference sugar and a test sugar to calculate the glycemic index. So the formula for the calculation of glycemic index is the area under the curve for the test sugar divided by the area under the curve for the reference sugar. We compare our test or the sample sugar with the reference sugar and then we multiply it with the 100. So this is the formula for the glycemic index. Now this was a short topic to be learned, but now another thing that is mostly asked and mostly used with the glycemic index is the another term that is called as the glycemic load. Now what is the glycemic load and what is the difference between glycemic load and glycemic index we are going to discuss. The glycemic load is actually a glycemic load of food is a number that estimates how much a food will raise a person's blood glucose level after one serving. It is not the rank of carbohydrate that raises the blood glucose more or less. It is the number that is given to carbohydrate that how much it raises the blood glucose after one serving. You can say if we take one serving of the rice, it going to increase your glycemic index how much, or it will going to increase your blood sugar level how much. So in one serving, how much increase in blood glucose level, this will calculated by the glycemic load. So it is the per serving. It is calculated by per servings. So it has been a difference between the glycemic index and glycemic load. Also, we can compare the glycemic index with the glycemic load by the certain foods. Like if we take an example of wheat, in the low glycemic index, wheat is a low glycemic index food because it will not causing the increased shooting of the blood glucose level when taken normally in one serving. So it is a low glycemic index food, but the wheat is a high glycemic load food. You can say it has the high glycemic load. Why? Because a per serving of the wheat contains many grains of the wheat. They are about 100 to 20. We cannot count the wheat grains, so we cannot count the rice. So in per serving there is a large amount. So the glycemic load of the wheat is greater, but the glycemic index of the wheat is less. So it happens that certain foods with the low glycemic index have high glycemic load, or the certain foods which have high glycemic index may have the low glycemic load. So this was a general difference between the glycemic index and glycemic load. I hope you will be explained well. Thank you for watching and subscribe for more. If you have any query, comment below, give feedback on our Facebook page, and keep sharing, keep subscribing. Thank you for watching.